Supernova. Is it going to destroy our beautiful planet Earth at some point in the future, or are we actually safe from such an event? Today we're going to be talking about the possibility of Earth being destroyed by a supernova, or what may happen sometime in the future to one of the stars near us. Welcome to What the Math? Today we're going to talk about the end of the world, or the possibility of such thing. And I think the best thing I can do right now is start by basically telling you that our sun is not going to go through a supernova. Our sun is going to have a much, much smaller event sometime 5 or possibly 6 billion years from now that will not actually affect our Earth as much as this particular event that you're about to see. And so the chance of a supernova from our own sun is non-existent, basically. It's not going to happen. But there is still a chance that there might be a star near us that has a potential for such an event. In other words, there is possibly, and actually very likely, a star that is not very far away from us that may actually do this: boil our Earth and destroy all of the life on it. Now, can it happen? Will it happen? Well, let's actually try to analyze this mathematically, scientifically, and try to figure out if we're going to be in danger at some point in the future. So let's actually start the simulation from scratch, because, like I said before, our sun is never going to have this. And having actually looked at all of the stars near our solar system, I found that there is at least one star that has a chance for a supernova. As a matter of fact, there is a star in a binary star system called this, IK Pegasi. And this star is also known as HR8210. This is a binary star that's approximately 150 light years away from our sun currently, and it's in a very interesting binary system. Now, this is actually the closest known candidate for a chance of a supernova. I'm going to talk more about supernovas in one of the future videos where I'll tell you about different types, but this particular star is actually the only star we know that may possibly undergo a supernova anytime from now to approximately 10 million years from now. So in the next 10 million years, it might actually have a supernova event. And HR8210 is actually present in the Universe Sandbox 2, but unfortunately it's not a binary star that it is in reality. It only shows you the bigger companion, which is a main sequence star that looks like this. It's about two masses of the sun. But the interesting thing about this particular star, also known as IK Pegasi, is that it actually has a white dwarf companion very close to it. And this is actually a more realistic representation of what the system looks like. So there is a central main sequence star in the middle, and there is a much smaller white dwarf right next to it. And these particular stars orbit around each other, creating a barycenter right here, right there. So they're basically orbiting around one another, and they have a relatively circular orbit in the sense that they basically don't really deviate too much from each other, and they don't have much eccentricity. And they've been doing this for millions and possibly even billions of years from the time when this star was actually a much bigger main sequence star itself. This actually used to be a star that was possibly as much as 8 times the mass of sun, but then this lost its shell, undergone what's known as a nova event, which is what will happen to our sun as well, lost its outer shell, and basically became a white dwarf. This is something that will happen to our sun as well in the future, and will also happen to many, many different stars, including this one here. But here's the interesting thing, though. And I kind of wonder if I can possibly emulate this here, but basically, in the future, sometime after a few million years, as IK Pegasi A actually gets older, it will eventually start expanding and will start growing larger and larger and larger, something that will happen to our sun as well. Now, we can actually simulate this by basically increasing its age right here to make it sort of look like what it would look like in the future. So you'll see that it's actually going to start larger in size. And here you go. Now, this is actually showing you hundreds of millions of years, but according to our calculation, this will not be that long. It will actually very likely happen within the next 10 million years, or possibly even sooner. Now, when this happens, at some point, it's going to get so large that its actual outer shell will be intersecting with the orbit of this other star, and this other star will actually start absorbing some of its mass. In other words, it will start growing bigger, it will start growing more massive. So the white dwarf will actually start eating up its larger cousin or its larger sister or brother. And it will actually get even bigger than this, to the point where the entire shell will cover this whole thing, whole orbital path. And so eventually it will basically cover the star, and that other star will start absorbing, and this is what will happen, absorbing its mass, and this will very likely cause a supernova inside the white dwarf. Now, there's a reason for that, and it's actually very interesting. I'm going to talk about this concept in the next video, because it's a concept that deserves its own video. It's something called Chandrasekhar limit. This is actually named after a relatively famous Indian mathematician that came up with this when he was only 19 years old. He actually was able to prove that there is a limit for every white dwarf where if it's below this limit, it will stay stable. If it's below this particular mass, I'm going to use Sirius B here just to show you what I'm talking about. Let's play Sirius B because that's a white dwarf. And so Sirius B currently has a mass of approximately 0.9 suns. Now, if this limit gets to about 1.4 masses of sun, which is actually, or actually 1.39, if it's about 1.39 masses of sun, it will still be stable. But as soon as it absorbs a little bit more mass, and as soon as it goes, as soon as it basically goes over that limit, that's what happens, supernova. Now, this is a concept we'll talk about in the next video, but basically, because of this, there's a very likely chance that IK Pegasi B will actually create a supernova sometime in the future. Now, this star is about 150 light years away from us right now, and so what I wanted to investigate is if we're actually in danger of being destroyed by this particular event. So let's actually recreate this using a regular simulation right here. We're going to place IK Pegasi A and B, and we're now also going to cause the smaller star to go into supernova by basically increasing the size of its partner star. So there we go. As soon as the partner size increases to a certain limit, that's what is going to happen. There we go. So it's going to cover everything here. And as soon as I start the game, supernova. So that will, we know that this will very likely happen in this star. And obviously, in sometime in the future, we'll also be able to see this in our night sky. Now we're going to zoom into Earth now. Where is our beautiful planet? And just observe this event in a distance for now. Now, the question I guess I have is, if it's at this distance from us, and let's actually just find it, where is it? And it's actually still right there, barely visible to us, so we'll have to advance time a little bit more before we can see it. So yes, if this event occurs, and if we actually are still on our planet Earth, are we going to basically die? And let's find out if we're actually in danger. So we're going to run the simulation advanced time, and I just want you to look at the date here. So right now it's 2020, and let's just say that it happened today. We're actually, you know, we're looking in the night sky and we see that there's a supernova in that particular star that's 150 light years away from us. Within the next few years, this is only year 7, it will grow larger and larger and will actually expand at about 10% of the speed of light. I'm going to wait and see until this thing gets to our solar system, and then would like to actually see if we're in any danger at all. So if, you know, what will actually happen. So basically we're going to accelerate time here and just run this for a few years until this beautiful supernova gets here. Now, it's already 2070, I'm going to be really, really old by then. 2080, hopefully still alive, still looking in the sky. The year is 2110, I think. Many of us are really, really old and possibly already dead. The supernova is growing exponentially large in our night sky. Our night sky is probably very, very beautiful right now, but at the same time, we're probably very, very scared about what is going to happen to us. Will we die or will we live? So, the supernova itself will actually be visible to us way before it actually gets here. So we'll actually see the light, we'll get to detect all of these various types of radiation. And this by itself is not particularly dangerous, but the shell, when it gets to our solar system, might actually cause a lot of damage. And depending on the distance we are from it when it occurs, we might be actually in trouble. So this is what I wanted to investigate and see if our planet is in any danger at all. Because there are different types of supernova, because there are different causes for supernova, it's also very likely that another type of a supernova might occur before this one. And so the chances for a supernova in the vicinity of our particular solar system are not very low. I mean, they're actually there, the chances are there. And so we might be able to see a supernova event even in our lifetime, even though it's... The last one actually happened many hundreds of years ago. We still might be able to see one that's relatively close to us. So, as you can see right now, it's much, much larger in our night sky now. But by itself, it's actually still pretty far away. So, if I were to zoom out, you can see that it's not even halfway there yet. And the year is already 2400. So, obviously, none of us are around anymore. So, even if it happens today, by the time it gets to our planet, your grand-grand-grand-grand-grand-grand-grandchildren will still not even be in any danger at all, because it's not there yet. And it will actually take several thousand years for any of these particles to even get to our solar system. So that's what I kind of wanted to show you, that even if a supernova occurs today and you see it in the night sky, by the time it actually gets to our solar system, and by the time it has any effect on our planet, it's going to be many, many thousands, if not millions, years in the future. It's now 900 years, and we're still running this at a relatively fast pace. And this is where the first of the particles might actually be able to reach our solar system, and we might start seeing some effects on our planet and in our solar system. But these effects will not be particularly dramatic. It's really, it's this other stuff that's very, very energetic, very supermassively energetic, and that actually potentially may cause our atmosphere to burn out and our water to evaporate, that very likely be able to reach our planet in the future. But depending on how far the supernova of IK Pegasi occurs from us, we might still be actually not in danger at all. So, because I initiated the supernova right now, but we also know that this particular star is actually moving away from us. So, but when it actually goes supernova, or if it goes supernova, it might be way, way more far away from us. As a matter of fact, the current estimate is at about 500 light years. So I detonated, or I initiated supernova a lot sooner than it will occur in reality. But let's actually just wait for all of this stuff to get to our solar system, and let's see what happens. So this is the first particles that actually approach our solar system. We will start witnessing some sort of effect. Very likely a lot of things like northern lights and southern lights, and basically all kinds of atmospheric effects will increase, because all of this is essentially very highly energized particles moving relatively fast, to some extent similar to solar flares that we experience on Earth. But if you look on our planet, if you actually look at Earth, it's, you know, it's not different yet. Nothing really happened here yet. So everyone is still alive, everyone is still well, even 1500 years after the supernova. And the year now is 4500. I'm going to slow down time just to show you if anything happened to our planet Earth. Let's zoom in here, because a lot of these particles have already actually made it to the solar system and are maybe affecting our planet. And the answer to that is, let's actually just look at the climate itself, just so that we can actually see what's going on here. And here we go. So you can see nothing is really different. We still have winters, we still have summers, we still have water and the atmosphere as well. So nothing really changed just yet. Let's accelerate time a little bit more. And so what this suggests is that, and this is actually what we know about the supernova in general, is that if the supernova occurs relatively far away from us, even though it's going to be so gorgeous and so beautiful thousands of years afterwards, it's very likely life on Earth will not really be affected. So we know today that for a supernova to actually cause a potential extinction event in our solar system and basically on Earth, it must be closer than about 10 parsecs, which is about 30 light years. This star went supernova at about 150 light years, which is 5 times as far away. So within 10 parsecs, within 30 light years, or I guess 32 light years, the chance for a potential damage and potential destruction is high. But if it's anywhere more than that, if it's more than 35 light years, for example, then it's going to be very beautiful. It may have some minor effects. It might have some atmospheric effects, like a lot of aurora borealis effects. Our sky might actually light up and look very, very gorgeous. But it may not really have any major harm to any kind of terrestrial biosphere or our planet, essentially. So, you know, if there are humans still around in about 3,000 years, when it's year almost 5,000, they will just witness this beautiful event, but nothing else will happen. So I'm going to actually run this for until at least year 10,000, just to see if anything actually occurs. And the year is now 10,400-500, so let's slow down. Actually, let's just zoom out first and see what this looks like. So yeah, we're almost in the middle of the supernova event, and our entire sky is essentially covered in this beautiful, shiny, and very highly energetic event. And so we might not even be able to see some of the stars anymore, because this is relatively bright. This is pretty bright. But if we zoom in on Earth, nothing changed. Everything is just as it should be. So this kind of gives me an answer, and hopefully gives you an answer, of what would happen if a supernova event occurred in a relatively close environment to our planet. And when I say close, I mean within about 100 light years from us. And this particular star I covered before, also known as HR8210 or IK Pegasi, is essentially the very likely candidate for the next supernova event in our vicinity, and may actually make our sky look like this in some relatively close future, possibly thousands of years, possibly millions of years, but very likely about 10 million years from now. If this happens, you should know that you have nothing to worry about, even if you're still around and somehow humanity survives that long and we're all immortal and super knowledgeable beings. If, however, we are not around, obviously our descendants, our grand-grand-grand-grandchildren have nothing to worry about. Anyway, thank you so much for watching, hopefully you enjoyed this video, and in the next video we're going to talk more about the idea of supernova and also Chandrasekhar limit, which is kind of important to explore as well. Thank you for watching, subscribe if you still haven't, like this video, share it with your friends or anyone else you think may like to watch space videos, and I'll see you in the next video. Game you later, guys, and as always, bye-bye.